Hello, and today is Monday, October 24th, and welcome to a bonus Zoom with Czarny. My name is Dustin Czarny. I'm the Democratic Elections Commissioner. And today I'm doing a short bonus Zoom with Czarny with my interview with Toby Shelley, who's the Democratic candidate who's running for sheriff. The reason I'm doing these bonuses is because we're running out of time. We're about 15 days away from Election Day, and I have a couple of more Zoom with Czarnys that I want to get out. So I wanted to make sure I got this one out. It's a little bit of a shorter interview than normal. Toby is a dynamic candidate who is running for sheriff again. And he has some really interesting views on law enforcement and what needs to be done here in Onondaga County. So I hope you stick around for the interview. I do want to mention the big news is probably the lawsuit on absentee ballots by New York State GOP. At the time of recording this, I'm still waiting to hear some news. You know, the ruling has come down, but that ruling is going to be appealed. And throughout the week, we're going to know more information. But the most important thing I want you to know is that you are still able to apply by absentee. If you're watching this on Monday the 24th, today is the last day to request an absentee. And yes, you can still use the COVID excuse. The only thing the ruling that came down on Friday did was prevent us from counting and canvassing absentees before Election Day, but it was still kind of vague about that as well. All of the ballots that are in our possession are still valid and going to be counted. Only thing that might happen if the appeal is not successful is that we may have to count some of these absentees after Election Day, like we did before. Again, I'll know more this week because the Attorney General and the state of New York is already planning to appeal this ruling. And when an appeal is done for a state law, there's an automatic stay. And if there is an automatic stay, that means that we will go back to processing absentees as normal. And there's still a question about whether we should be counting absentees as normal anyways. That ruling came down late on Friday. Most boards of elections had already processed their absentees that day. And we'll have to see what happens over this next week. So stay tuned. I got a lot of content coming from you this week, which I will probably tag this lawsuit in just about all of them. So stay tuned and, and I'll give you as much news as possible. So now I'll get to my interview with Toby Shelley, who's a sheriff's candidate running for Onondaga County Sheriffs. Bye-bye. And we're back. And I'm happy to have, welcome back to Zoom with Czarny. We're actually doing this in person this is the first time. Pandemic is getting away from this. So I'm going back to what I used to do before the pandemic. And I have my good friend here, Toby Shelley, who's running for sheriff in Onondaga County on the Democratic line. Toby, thanks for coming on Zoom with Czarny.
It's good to be here.
So Toby, I know you're no stranger to Democratic politics, but there's maybe a lot of people hearing this that don't know who you are. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Yeah, my name's Toby Shelley. I'm running for sheriff. I'm in my 28th year in law enforcement, 30-year military veteran, Iraqi war veteran, have extensive education and five college degrees, a master's degree in criminal justice, things like that. We own and operate a farm down in Tisco. It's been in my family 200 years, and we run an excavation business, my sons and I. So that's my background in a nutshell.
So you're running for sheriff this year. How important is it for people to vote in this office? This comes up every 4 years, always in the governor's year, but how important of a race is this for Onondaga County?
It's important for a number of reasons. I mean, the sheriff is a constitutional position, takes an oath of the Constitution, and I don't think people realize that public safety in Onondaga County is one-third of the county budget.
Yeah.
And the sheriff's department in particular is the third largest in New York State. It's a $120 to $130 million budget. Budget talks are going on now, so I don't have the exact number. 660 members there, so it's a big operation. There's a lot going on, and it takes a lot of money. And it's your public safety that's at stake.
So, this is not your first run for sheriff. You've run a couple times before, but what do you think are some of the major issues that are facing this department and why you want to lead it?
Well, there's a lot of issues facing the department and police in general. I mean, building the public trust is a huge issue. especially in today's world, and bring in the integrity, the transparency, the accountability that's necessary to do that is what's lacking in the Sheriff's Department now. And I've been talking about those issues all the times I've run, and every run I've done is built to the next run. It's very hard to run for sheriff as a Democrat. There's only been one in 228 years. So we continue to build on those things, those integrity issues, transparency issues.
And as you said, it's a countywide office, so that's not a small lift. You have to build a pretty large campaign, in a lot of grassroots efforts to go into it. What are some of the responses that you're getting from the public as you're out there?
As I say, every campaign I've done is built on the next, so the name recognition we've had, we've already done the hard work and paid for that. So it's just a matter of building on that. And to win the sheriff, you really have to flip votes. And that's the challenge as a Democrat. How do you get a Republican or a conservative to vote for a Democrat? Because there's always an undervote in the city. Some people just will never vote for a police officer. So those are things we have to make up. And we're doing that with a common sense approach.
So what are you hoping to do if you're elected, when you're elected sheriff? It's an open seat, first time it's been an open seat in quite some time. When you're elected sheriff, what's your platform? What are you trying to do at the sheriff's department?
One of the biggest issues we're working on is improving morale. And as a history major, when you look back at the 78 election between Corbett and Dillon actually ran on morale. And people at first don't think about that, but when you think about morale, you start to realize all the benefits that come from that. I mean, you reduce sick leave, it solves some of your retention problems, it solves some of your recruiting problems, and on. And improved morale is one of the biggest issues we're gonna work on, especially when you start looking at two jails, which have issues as far as consolidation, disparity of pay, and on. So improved morale is one of our biggest issues, believe it or not.
So you talked about the two jails, because I happened to be at my budget hearing this today, and the current sheriff was there before me, and he said that he wanted to consolidate the two jails. What are your thoughts about that?
Well, I think we keep the two jails, but try and bring it under one umbrella. And to do that, we have to fix the disparity in pay, and we have to work out the issue of seniority. So if you have 20 years seniority in Jamesville, and you want to come downtown, you don't want to lose that. So we have to work those out between the two unions, get everybody at the table. And once we work out the seniority issue, then we can work out the two different jails issue and try and get two jails, one umbrella.
So what is your plan for November? I mean, we're now at the time we're taping this, I'm not sure when this is going to air, but the time we're taping this, we're less than 50 days away from the election. What is your plan, from now until November?
Well, every night we're out getting the message out. I mean, Monday night I was out at the Central New York Sportsman's Club, and I was probably the only Democrat standing in the room. And those type of events are how we're flipping the votes, getting the message out. And what's most significant in this race is people need to realize I'm the only police officer in this race. And it's important that your top cop be a cop. That's what I hear the most about. That's what we talk a lot about. It's disaster by design having the top cop not be a cop.
All right. Well, Toby, before I end the interview, where can people find you on, I know you have a Facebook page, right?
And, absolutely.
Do you have a website too?
We have a website. It's ShelleyForSheriff.com.
And I'll put that in the show notes for you to click on.
Excellent. We have Act Blue on there. Of course, we need your votes. We need all your money. I mean, it's a standard line for all candidates.
Sure.
It's the money gets the message out.
So I always like to end these interviews with what haven't we talked about now? So what haven't we talked about that you wanted to get out there, either about yourself or about the race in general?
There's a lot of issues we could talk all day about, but it's not just Toby Shelley you're voting for. My team has almost 200 years experience, and it's insider experience. And to be successful as a leader, you have to surround yourself with good people. And that's where other people have fallen, and that's where we're not going to fall.
All right. Toby, thank you so much for coming on to Czarny. Go out there and vote. I think the time this airs, early voting will be just a couple weeks away. Make sure you go vote, get an absentee ballot, and vote blue all the way. And Toby, thank you for coming on.
Yep. Thank you for your time.
Bye-bye.
And that was my interview with Toby Shelley, Democratic candidate for sheriff here in Onondaga County. So please check out his show. In the show notes will be his links to his Facebook pages and everything else. So please check that out. Coming this week, I have a lot of content for you. This week and next week, we have Zoom with Czarnys on Monday and Thursday. Today is Monday. On Thursday, I'll be having a Zoom with Czarny with Jimmy Monto, who is a candidate for 5th District Council. I also have a Commissioner Carr coming on Tuesday. We'll be talking about early voting and, of course, the absentee lawsuit that's going on. And then on Wednesday, I'll be doing a special bonus weekly wonk on the town of Onondaga. And then on Sunday, a regular weekly wonk on the town of Pompeii. So I got content coming up for you Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Sunday. And who knows? I'm sure there'll be some stuff on Friday and Saturday as well as we get closer to the election. You know, early voting does start this Saturday, the 29th. So get out there and early vote as well. And you can find all your information at onvote.net and apply for an absentee ballot if you do it before midnight on the 24th as well. So thank you very much for tuning into Zoom with Czarny. Take care. Bye-bye.